There's treasure children always seek to find.
Hey friends, this is part three of my treasure subseries with another generous box from Michael. This one contains a variety of things, 45s, CDs, SACDs, and some books too. There's really just one or two items here that are more what I call Elton related. Everything else is 100% pure Elton. No additives, not from concentrate. And we're going to begin with the 45s. There are two bunches. This is the first, very well wrapped. And here we go. First 45 in neon, back with Tactics, U.S. Geffen Grey Label, released in November 1984 as a Geffen exclusive. I had a copy already. Glad to have two. I'm amazed at how good that 45 sounds. Johnny B. Good, 1979 U.S. MCA 10 and beige label. This is the single edit, which is a merciful 3 minutes and 22 seconds. The B-side, Georgia, was an album track from a single man and is a great song. Victim of Love, U.S. MCA 10 and beige label, also released in 1979. This song was a big hit in certain parts of South America. Here in North America, though, it sank like a lead balloon. Lucy in the Sky, One Day at a Time, 1974, U.S. MCA Black Rainbow copy. Simple Life, 1993, U.S. MCA Blue Rainbow. I still don't know why these early 90s Elton 45s on Blue Rainbow were made, but they exist. That A-side is the single remix, too. Don't Go Breaking My Heart, back with Snow Queen, 1976, USMCA Rocket Green Label. My fourth copy of this, second American copy. True Love, back with Runaway Train, 1993, USMCA Blue Rainbow. Another of these early 90s MCA Blue Rainbow 45s. I love True Love. I hated it for years, and then I got a little older and I fell in love with it. Runaway Train, back with Understanding Women, 1992 USMCA Blue Rainbow, two great tracks from The One. Your Song, backed with Take Me to the Pilot, mid-1970s USMCA Black Rainbow copy, reissue. I haven't played this copy yet, but I presume that both tracks are in stereo here, not in mono. The Bitch is Back, 1974 USMCA Black Rainbow. This is my first copy of this single on MCA. Lady Samantha, It's Me That You Need, a mid-1970s USMCA Black Rainbow copy, reissue. Both tracks still in mono here. The only true stereo mix of Lady Samantha is on Rare Masters. Philadelphia Freedom, back with I Saw Her Standing There, live version at Madison Square Garden, a 1975 USMCA Black Rainbow copy, my first American copy. And although it's a 45, this contains the original full-length version of Philly Freedom. Nobody Wins, back with Fools in Fashion, 1981 U.S. Geffen Grey Label, a great single. I have so many copies of this now, but I don't care. I love it. The B-side, Fools in Fashion, is a gem too. Just a great song. Killer outro on Fools in Fashion. Healing Hands, Dancing in the End Zone, 1989 USMCA Blue Rainbow copy. A fantastic A-side here. Never understood the B-side or what that song is about, Dancing in the End Zone. It's not about football. Bite Your Lip, Get Up and Dance, backed with Chameleon, 1977 U.S. Rocket MCA Electric Train label. One of Elton's first flops, as his star began its descent in the late 70s. The A-side is an edit of the 12-inch remix by Tom Moulton. I don't know if the B-side was edited. I'm Still Standing, Love So Cold, 1983 U.S. Geffen Grey label. One of Elton's all-time classic singles. I love the B-side, Love So Cold, too. Sad Songs, 1984 U.S. Geffen Grey label. Sad Song's a good song, if you're drunk. Nikita, 1985, U.S. Geffen Black Label. I like Nikita, beautiful song, but the reason you get that 45 is the Wembley 84 live version of Restless on the flip side. Something About the Way You Look Tonight, backed with Candle in the Wind, 1997. This is a U.S. Rocket copy from 1997. I often forget that Candle 97 was the B-side, not the A-side. Part-Time Love, backed with I Cry at Night, 1978 USMCA Tan and Beige original, which is noteworthy because the original Canadian copies of this on MCA were Black Rainbow label copies. I have no idea why. And the last of this bunch, Step Into Christmas, backed with Ho Ho Ho, Who'd Be a Turkey at Christmas, 1973 USMCA Black Rainbow copy, my first American copy of that single. Okay, and now 45 bunch number two. Now, there's a reason that Michael wrapped those bunches in wrapping paper. It's a long story. I'll tell you another time. Here we go. Heartache All Over the World, 1986, U.S. Geffen Black Label with Sleeve. Leather Jacket sucks, but I've always loved Heart of Gold Over the World. This is the 7-inch version with the edit piece at the start. Wrapper Up, backed with The Man Who Never Died, 1985 U.S. Geffen Black Label with sleeve. Catchy A-side, but the B-side, The Man Who Never Died, was written and recorded just after John Lennon's death and is a tribute to Lennon. But the B-side version here was a remix done in 1985 by Gus Dudgeon. Kiss the Bride, 1983 U.S. Geffen Grey Label with sleeve. Great A-side. The B-side, Chalk Ice Goes Mental, is an instrumental and is indeed mental. It's a cool track. Who Wears These Shoes, back with Lonely Boy, 1984 U.S. Geffen Grey Label with sleeve. I dislike both these songs. The look on Elton's face in the picture sleeve pretty much says it all. I'm Still Standing, the 1983 Dutch Rocket copy with sleeve. This is the Rocket version of the single, whose B-side was not Love So Cold, but rather Earn While You Learn, the full-length 7-minute version. I Don't Want to Go On With You Like That, backed with Rope Around a Fool, 1988 USMCA Blue Rainbow with sleeve. We saw a CD version of that in the last video. This is an MCA copy on 45, two tracks only. Believe, 1995 U.S. Rocket issue with sleeve. I now have three copies of that 45. They were all made in the U.S. and pressed by Specialty Records in Pennsylvania with lacquers cut by Chris Bellman. Take Me to the Pilot, the Live in Australia version, 1988 USMCA Blue Rainbow with sleeve. I have a Canadian white label promo of this. Canadian promos are not hard to find, but I've never seen a Blue Rainbow stock copy. That's an American stock copy. Song for Guy, 1979 USMCA Tan and Beige with sleeve, a great single, Song for Guy. The B-side, Lovesick, was a great danceable song with a string arrangement by Paul Buckmaster. Blue Eyes, 1982 US Geffen Grey Label with sleeve. Blue Eyes is a beautiful song, a little too soft for my taste, but it's beautiful. Its B-side, Hey Papa Legba, was a 21-33 outtake. This is Empty Garden, Take Me Down to the Ocean, 1982 U.S. Geffen, label with sleeve, a brilliant single, A and B-sides alike. Little Genie, 1980 USMCA custom label with sleeve, a hit for Elton in the summer of 1980. The B-side, Conquer the Sun, was yet another single Man Sessions outtake. Just love the custom label on that 45. That's What Friends Are For, Dionne Warwick and Friends, 1985 U.S. Arista with sleeve. I don't like the song too much. I guess I've just heard it too many times. 1983 U.S. Geffen Grey Label promo of I Guess That's Why They Call It the Blues. A-side is in mono, and the B-side is the same song in stereo. I already have one of these. It's nice to have two copies because they're pretty hard to find. Mama Can't Buy You Love, 1979 USMCA Tan and Beige label with sleeve. A great single. A Word in Spanish, Heavy Traffic, 1988 USMCA Blue Rainbow with sleeve. Not too crazy about the A-side, but the B-side I love. So that was it for the 45s. This is a stack of copies of a Best Buy promo from 2004 called Sweet Tracks, U.S. Promo Disc in Tin. It included Elton's cover of the song Makin' Whoopee, the solo version. He later re-recorded that as a duet with Rod Stewart, and that appeared on one of Rod's many cover versions albums from that period. I'm not a big Rod Stewart guy, so I don't know too much more about it than that, but Michael sent me about 7 copies of that CD in its original tin case. That was how Best Buy distributed those. Michael sent me a few other copies earlier in the spring, so I now have like 10 copies of those tins. Next is a book, Nigel Goodall's Elton John, a visual documentary, published in the U.S. by Omnibus Press, 1995. It's quite a book. I didn't have a copy before. It has lots of photos in it that, at the time, would have been difficult to find anywhere else, even on the internet. It's basically an illustrated timeline or chronology up to the mid-90s, and it includes a pretty decent discography, too, at the back. Next is 6 copies of the same DVD. It's an Elizabeth Town sneak preview promo DVD from 2006. It was for the Cameron Crowe film, Elizabeth Town. It includes featurettes plus an excerpt from the film, the part when Elton's My Father's Gun plays in the movie. I don't really show it that well here, but in my hands is a copy of Hercules fanzine. I can't remember whether this was a normal issue or not. I think it was from around 2000 or so. I should have double-checked that before recording this. Okay, so now onto the CDs and SACDs. The original cases weren't available for these, so for shipping, Michael packed each title into a padded envelope, and this first one is supposed to be a Westwood One CD from 1999. I haven't played it yet. I don't know exactly what it is, but I seriously doubt it's a legitimate Westwood release. I think it's just made to look like one. Turn the Lights Out, When You Leave, UK EU CD single from 2005, the blue version, a great A-side from Peachtree Road, but those non-LP B-sides, How's Tomorrow and Peter's Song, are just divine. What great songs those are. Hard to believe they didn't make the album. An SACD, Honky Chateau, from 2004, 5.1 multi-channel remix version by Greg Penny. One of the six albums that were released in 5.1 that year, and it's an amazing way to experience that album, those multi-channel mixes. The next one should be, okay, All That I'm Allowed, in 2005 UK CD single, another Peachtree single with a non-LP B-side that I think beats the A-side. In this case, Keep It a Mystery. Just great B-sides, those Peachtree singles. Another SACD, Elton John, self-titled, 5.1 multi-channel mix by Greg Penny. Probably my favorite version of that album on any format. It's just a really fantastic way to experience that album. I think the next one is an SACD too. Yeah, here it is. Peachtree Road, 2004, 5.1 multi-channel version, mixed for 5.1 by Matt Still. The stereo mix is fine, but the 5.1 mix is stunning and was one of the reasons that I later fell in love with that album so much. It's almost like it was made for 5.1. It's like a completely different album in some ways in 5.1. This is Telltale's Interview Disc, originally released in 1996 in the UK. Despite the disc's appearance, this is actually an interview that was taped in late 1975, just before the Westies album came out. It's an interesting interview. Poor tape source, though. Very, very hissy. You really have to crank the volume to hear what Elton's saying. Original Sin, 2002 UK CD single, Part 1, which comes with a video, but it's not the video for Original Sin. It comes with the video for This Train Don't Stop There Anymore. Anyway, Original Sin, great song from the West Coast album. Another SACD, Madman Across the Water, 5.1 multi-channel remix by Greg Penny. This was the mix that was reissued in 2022 on Blu-ray audio, part of the Madman Across the Water 50th Anniversary Super Deluxe Edition, which is still out there, and if you don't have it, get it. It's so amazing. Okay, so I'm getting some more envelopes here. Now, you remember at the end of my last video, there was that box of empty jewel cases. Those were for these discs, okay, the discs that arrived in the padded envelopes. Another CD single here, I Want Love, 2001 UK CD single, Part 1, with a video for the A-side I Want Love. It also has the non-LP bonus track, The North Star, which I love. Great non-LP B-sides from the West Coast album, too. Please, 1996 UK Rocket CD single, Part 1 version, also with some Junior Sound Factory remixes of the song Made in England. Okay, here's the other Original Sin CD single. This is UK CD single, Part 2. Comes with the video for Original Sin, which had Mandy Moore and Elizabeth Taylor in it, which I thought was really cool. Great song, great video. Something About the Way You Look Tonight, the original 1997 UK CD single, later withdrawn and replaced with the Candle in the Wind 1997 version. This version has the bonus track I Know Why I'm in Love, which is a great non-LP track from a not-so-great album. Healing Hands, a 1989 UK Rocket CD single, comes with Dancing in the End Zone and, exclusive to the CD single, live version of Sad Songs Say So Much from the Verona, Italy concert, 1989, which you have probably seen. It's easy to find on YouTube. It's a great concert. Your Song, 2002 version. This is the US CD single. Elton re-recorded it with Alessandro Safina. I used to have a copy of this. I didn't keep it. I wasn't so crazy about it. I'm happy to have a copy back in my collection. This Train Don't Stop There Anymore, 2001 UK CD single. This is the Part 2 version. And as bonus tracks, we get some live tracks. I prefer the other version, Part 1, which I think we're going to see in a few minutes. Or we're going to see it right now. This is a 2001 UK CD single, Part 1. Which comes with the non-LP B-side or bonus track, Did Anybody Sleep with Joan of Arc? Strange title for a great song. Madman Demos, this is a bootleg, year unknown. It says DJM there, that's a bogus DJM. This is definitely a bootleg. Includes five piano demos, same demos that were later re-released on the 2022 Super Deluxe Edition. What's interesting here is that the sound quality for that bootleg is really good. SACD, another one. Tumbleweed Connection, 5.1 multi-channel remix by Greg Penny. And that, too, is like all the multi-channel SACDs Greg Penny did. It's just fantastic. If you can get them, if you can find a player that plays SACDs, you won't be disappointed. I'm getting the last stack of envelopes here. Okay. Turn the Lights Out When You Leave, 2005 UK CD single, the pink version, which has only one non-LP bonus track on it, but it's called Things Only Get Better With Love. Great song. SACD, 5.1 multi-channel remix of Captain Fantastic, the only one of all the released 5.1 multi-channel remixes that Penny remixed from an original 24-track tape. Written in the Stars, 1999 UK CD single. Bonus tracks are some outtakes from the Live at the Ritz album from the previous year. Recover Your Soul, 1998 UK CD single. This is the version with the video. You get a single remix, and you get the album version, and you get the video. And this is the other version of the same single, UK CD single for Recover Your Soul. Has the bonus track, Big Man in a Little Suit, which is not the greatest song in the world, but I love it anyway. It's an amusing song. Another non-LP bonus track from an otherwise not so great album. Live Like Horses, 1996 UK CD single. It includes the solo studio version of that song, as well as the duet version with Pavarotti, and a live version of I Guess That's Why They Call It the Blues. And then here, okay, this is, again, this is a bootleg. It's meant to look like some kind of BBC radio-only promo disc, but it's just a, it's not, it's a bootleg. A couple of Reg Dwight covers on here, two versions of Bridge Over Troubled Water, and then a cover version of a song called Dark Side of the Moon, no relation to the Pink Floyd song. I Want Love, 2001 UK CD single, part two version. Includes the non-LP bonus track, God Never Came There. If the River Can Bend, 1998 UK CD single with the green sleeve. It's the same master recording, but it was sped up for single release. It's a slightly faster and a semitone higher in pitch. And last but not least, the 1990 UK CD single for You Gotta Love Someone comes with the bonus track Medicine Man, the original version, and the Adamski remix version, which is cool. I love that version. And I think that's it for this box. Yeah, it is. Thank you again to Michael for his very generous donations to my collection. Further episodes of this sub-series will focus on items sent in from other viewers and friends. Please like and subscribe if you haven't already. That really helps newer startup YouTube channels like this one grow and survive. And of course, as always, thanks for watching. See you again soon.